Hello, it is quite late now, and well, at first, about I am putting the camera quite far from me because I don't want to touch it until I am finished with recording, because I don't want the webcam to freeze the frame. Maybe it still will, but I don't know because of the system or anything. Well, today, at first I thought it would be a very, very boring day, like routine, but it turns out to be a very different and interesting one. A little bit tired. At the morning, I got this. These are the earrings with pink, hot pink feathers, which I got for my birthday. It is sent from Belgium of a friend of mine. It is a late birthday gift, so thank you. And secondly, that I just got home. It is around 12 a.m. now, and I just got home around 50 minutes before, because today it is quite a long day at work. I am learning about banking and finance, so I know about a little bit about finance, about stuff, about numbers, about accounting, but at the same time I don't like it a lot because I'm not good at it. But today I have a customer. Her name is Jessica. Hi Jessica, if you are watching this video right now. She asked me to do some bills for her, and yep, and be and hope and how to say it, not fortunately, I am in college. We did it well, and I have those as a gift from Jessica to be in doing the nice work, not nice work, doing the good job. And well, I am a girl and I like flowers. That is why I am so happy about it. When I went home later than usual today, I bring that bouquet of flower back home. All my cousins who are living here with me, they are like, "Who do you gone out with? Who is the boy?" Because often when I, especially me, when I bring flowers at home, back to home, it means that there is a guy, kind of wanting to have my attention. But yes, it's been a long time since I get flowers from anyone. Just because, for my birthday, I get presents instead, and I don't have a boyfriend or someone is trying to getting to know me, so that is why they all were excited to see that flower bouquet that I brought home. So not brought home, brought home, yes. So Jessica, when you're watching it, this video right now, I believe that you are in the UK. Maybe you are enjoying your weekend after the long trip in Vietnam, or maybe you are in your work days. I'm not sure, but I am wishing you a nice days and nice week, whatever the time it is there, and wish you many success. And there's one thing I wanted to tell you before, but I don't know that tomorrow morning I will tell you or not, or I will leave it here. That is, I found you to be a very charming woman, and that is what I admire in you, and it is the main, maybe the main reason I ask for to have your connection, your contact. It sounds creepy now, because I am a girl and I tell you that I find you very charming and asking for your contact. Wow. Because I don't know how to put it, how to say it. I am not good at judging people, but I feel I have the kind of sometimes I feel the personalities through the way they speak or to the gestures, to the body languages, and I find I have some feeling from you which is classy, outgoing, strict, and nice. All of this and some more that I don't know how to explain it are combined together, and I find it very charming. And it is normal because finding it charming doesn't mean that I admire you doesn't mean that I am some kind of having feelings that is how to say it. Long story short, it means that I find you charming and I want to grow as a person like you because in 10 or 20 years' time, I don't know, but I have a feeling that you are the type of person, a type of person with the human, with the personality, with the knowledge and all the gesture, all the things that you express is something that I don't see much, especially around me. And that is what I find it is unique from you, but at the same time, something unique, but not kind of crazy or too different from others. That is what I think that women in general should have. So if all the people are kind of like you, it is always making a better world. That is why I have the feeling that I need to learn from you more. I not like that I need to get to know you. It's difficult to express. It is just that when speaking to you, I can learn from your knowledge or from the way you are speaking things, the way you are expressing things, that then I can learn it from myself that in those conditions or problems or issues or situations, I should react like this, like that, like those, because I knew many people who react in many things and I can conclude it into the way that is me. And that is why I find you very different and charming, and I want to learn from you. And one thing more is it is about maybe I admire your job also because I am very interested in making events, charity, and organizing things, social work in general. That is why I would like to be your friend, and I hope that saying those things doesn't get too much that makes you find that I'm impolite or getting to your private space because that is very different from the cultures. Sometimes here in Vietnam we have the tend to ask too much the private life, which is means to be caring and to get to know each other and to being friends, and with some Western people it is like stepping into the private zone, which is not good and which is which make them feel uncomfortable. Oh my God, I cannot talk now. I'm very tired. And yeah, so I think I should not explain more because the more I explain, the more confusing it will become. So I think I will leave the story now and wish you all a nice day. Good night, everyone. And PS to Jessica, if you're watching this video, so and still watching it till now, I think that I would like to control no to what to exchange with you more, to talk with you more about all the issues, or not the issues, everything, to emails, because how to say it, I admire you and find you charming, and I have a feeling that you are someone that I can learn from, that is like a bigger sister that has beauty, knowledge, independence, and charm. So thank you and have a good night. Tomorrow is another busy day, so bye. Stop.